Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. In this presentation, we are going to study about cofactors and coenzymes. If you take enzyme, it is a protein. Almost all enzymes are protein except ribozyme. And this protein part of enzyme is called apoenzyme. Several enzymes, apart from being a protein, they also possess non-protein component. So such non-protein components are called cofactors. So cofactors are non-protein component. So this non-protein component of enzyme, we can call it as prosthetic groups. So now we have apoenzyme and we have prosthetic groups. So together, this enzyme and cofactors or apoenzyme and prosthetic group, we can call it as a holoenzyme. So holoenzyme is nothing but enzyme or apoenzyme plus non-protein component or prosthetic groups. So the prosthetic groups are collectively called as cofactors. And these cofactors could be coenzymes or metal ions. Okay, don't confuse for coenzymes and cofactors. So coenzymes are also cofactors, even metal ions are also cofactors. So usually these cofactors enhances enzymatic reactions or enzyme catalyzed reactions. So usually coenzymes are organic components, whereas metal ions are inorganic. First, we will discuss about coenzymes. So in the coenzyme, there are two types of coenzymes. The first category of coenzymes, which usually involves transfer of electrons. We already studied in the enzyme classification. So electrons are transferred mainly by oxidoreductases. So these coenzymes usually participate in oxidation reduction reactions. The other category of coenzymes are, they helps in group transfer, functional group transfer. The coenzymes are organic components and they are prosthetic groups and they are non-protein component and they are classified into two categories. Those coenzymes which usually helps in transfer of electron. So they can accept electron from the substrate. And another group of coenzymes are, they usually involve in transfer of groups like functional groups, carboxyl group, amino group. We will see the example. First, we will discuss in detail about coenzymes. And usually these coenzymes are low molecular weight organic compounds. These coenzymes are loosely attached to the enzyme and they can be separated easily by dialysis. Since they are loosely attached, we can separate these coenzymes from the enzyme by dialysis. And these coenzymes are transiently involved in enzyme catalyzed reaction. These coenzymes are transient or temporary carriers, either electrons or functional groups. So they are transient carriers, the carriers of electrons or functional groups. So they usually carry electrons or functional groups from the substrate. Most of the coenzymes are derived from water-soluble vitamins, like vitamin B complex. Majority of coenzymes are derived from water-soluble vitamins. There are few coenzymes, they are not derived from water-soluble vitamins, like lipoate, even coenzyme Q. We will see this cofactor in electron transport chain. And another coenzyme other than water-soluble vitamin is ATP. ATP also act as coenzyme. So here in this table, I have different coenzymes which are derived from water-soluble vitamins. These coenzymes usually helps in transfer of electrons, FAD and FMN, flavin adenine dinucleotide, FMN stands for flavin mononucleotide. Both these coenzymes are derived from vitamin B2 or riboflavin. And another vitamin B3, water-soluble vitamin B3 or niacin, their coenzymes or active forms are NAD and NADP, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. So both this riboflavin and niacin, their active forms or coenzymes are category 1 coenzymes. That means they usually helps in transfer or accepting the electrons from the substrate. In other words, they participate in oxidation reduction reactions catalyzed by oxidoreductases. So another coenzyme is thiamine pyrophosphate, TPP. It is derived from water-soluble vitamin thiamine or B1. All these coenzymes, they are involved in transfer of functional group. Pyridoxine or B6, the active form or coenzyme form of this vitamin is pyridoxal phosphate. They usually help in transfer of amino group from one compound to another compound. Similarly, biotin, which is a water-soluble vitamin, it helps in transfer of carboxyl group. Folic acid, the active form or coenzyme form of folic acid is tetrahydrofolate, which helps in transfer of one carbon group or one carbon metabolism. Another vitamin is, water-soluble vitamin is pantothenic acid. Its coenzyme is coenzyme A. It helps in transfer of acyl group, or it is acyl carrier. Acyl means fatty acids. Methylcobalamin is a coenzyme of vitamin B12 or cyanocobalamin, and this coenzyme usually involves in transfer of methyl group. So the first two, B2 and B3, their coenzymes, they help in transfer of electrons, or they involved in oxidation reduction reactions. All other coenzymes are group transfer coenzymes, or they involve in transfer of functional groups. These are the example of coenzymes. They are mainly derived from water soluble vitamins. Other than water soluble vitamins, there are coenzymes or cofactors like lipoate, ATP, coenzyme Q. We will see the specific example of these coenzymes so you will understand better. I will write a reaction where NAD or nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide acts as a coenzyme. Lactic acid or lactate converted to pyruvate and catalyzed by enzyme lactate dehydrogenase. This reaction takes place in both directions. It is a reversible reaction. This particular reaction requires a coenzyme derived from niacin. It is NAD plus. This NAD plus accepts electron from lactate and it will be converted to NADH plus H plus. I will explain this reaction with the structure. So let me draw the structure of lactic acid or lactate. So this is a lactate. So in this reaction, the enzyme is lactate dehydrogenase. In this reaction, the coenzyme is NAD plus or nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. You see here, in this nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, initially it accepts one electron. You can see this hydrogen and this hydrogen from the lactic acid. One hydrogen is equal to one proton and one electron. From the lactic acid, two hydrogen are accepted by this coenzyme, that is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide or NAD plus. There is a plus sign here, that means it immediately can accept one electron from the one of the hydrogen, and this NAD will become now NAD because it accept one of the electron from one of the hydrogen. Say for example, this hydrogen has got H plus and one electron. Initially this NAD, it accept one electron so that it will become NAD. Now the another hydrogen will be added, so it will become NADH. So now what is remaining? The remaining is H plus. It will be released into the medium. Since this reaction is reversible, we can put here also. Now this lactate will be converted to pyruvate. The structure looks like this. So this is the structure of pyruvate. So here from the substrate, this coenzyme accept the two hydrogen. In that, one full hydrogen which contains proton and electron and one electron, so that NAD plus will become NADH. So the remaining one proton will be released to the medium. So this is the action of coenzyme which involves in oxidation reduction reaction. We will see another example where coenzyme helps in transfer of functional groups. I will take an example of acetyl-CoA. So this is the first reaction of fatty acid synthesis. So initially acetyl-CoA will be converted to malonyl-CoA. And enzyme for this particular reaction is acetyl-CoA carboxylase. The EC number for this particular enzyme is 6412. So it is 6 means it belongs to class 6, that means ligases. We already studied ligases means the two molecules will be combined together to form a single compound. Here first substrate is acetyl-CoA, and this particular reaction also requires another substrate which is bicarbonate. Now you can understand there are two substrates here. They are combined together by ligase acetyl-CoA carboxylase to form one compound, that is malonyl-CoA. For this enzyme acetyl-CoA carboxylase, biotin acts as a coenzyme. So this coenzyme involved in transfer of group. Here there are two substrates. This is one substrate, this is another substrate. This biotin accept, here we have bicarbonate, it accepts carbon dioxide HCO3- from that CO2 will be accepted by biotin. In turn, biotin will be converted to carboxybiotin. Now this carboxybiotin combines with the first substrate. What is the first substrate? Acetyl-CoA. Pay attention here. There are two substrates, acetyl-CoA and bicarbonate. From the bicarbonate, carbon dioxide moiety will be accepted by coenzyme biotin, and biotin will be converted to carboxybiotin. And this carboxybiotin now combines with the first substrate, acetyl-CoA, to give product malonyl-CoA and biotin. This particular reaction also requires another cofactor, because ligases usually they utilize hydrolysis of ATP for the energy. ATP will be converted to ADP and inorganic phosphate. So this is the action of coenzyme transfer of functional group. Now we will move on to metalloenzyme. Metalloenzymes means they are cofactors, but they are metal ions. You know, coenzymes are loosely attached or non-covalently attached to the enzyme. Whereas some metal ions, either they can bond to enzymes loosely or sometimes covalently or tightly. Example, here we have a copper or cuprous. The enzyme which requires copper is cytochrome oxidase. So we call metalloenzyme. Metalloenzyme means enzymes which require metal ions. Similarly, cytochrome oxidase and catalase, they require ferrous, that is iron. Hexokinase, pyruvate kinase, they require magnesium. Similarly, glutathione peroxidase requires selenium. Zinc is a metal ion for carbonic anhydrase. So the summary, most of the enzyme requires an additional group called prosthetic group. They are called cofactors, whereas enzyme is called a apoenzyme. So apoenzyme and cofactor together, they are known as holoenzyme. Again, cofactor could be coenzymes or metal ions. Coenzyme, there are again two types. Those coenzyme involve in oxidation reduction reaction, and those coenzymes involve in transfer of functional group from one compound to another compound. And coenzymes are organic component, whereas metal ions are inorganic components. Majority of the coenzymes are derived from water-soluble vitamins. Apart from water-soluble vitamin-derived coenzymes, we also have lipoate and coenzyme Q. Metalloenzymes are usually enzymes which require metal ions for their optimum activity, like cytochrome oxidase, which requires copper ion. Thanks for watching.